Hey, all right, everybody, Dr. Cranky back with part two of the painting of the engine. In this case, I'm going to be painting. You can tell I'm ready. I have my mask ready, and I'm putting on the old gloves to protect the hands and also to keep clean. You know, I mean, it's you don't want to get messy. Anything other than acrylics in terms of paint gets pretty messy. You know, because you're going to need a thinner to clean stuff up, not just regular water. I'm a big proponent of when you mix your paint. In this case, this is enamel paint cut with cheap lacquer thinner. Okay, I put them in these 2 ounce bottles, and I usually mix it, you know, mix enough color to about here, and that'll do a model and plus a few surprises, you know. There's probably less than half an ounce of paint in here, which is just enough to get that new engine painted. In this case, also, I'm going to be trying out an Awada HP TR2, which has a bigger needle and a cup, and it's a trigger gun, so that I can get nice smooth coats of paint on the engine. You don't want to bomb your engine with paint, you know, because the detail is going to disappear, and you're going to see in the process it's all about layering in, you know, misting a little bit of the paint at first, and then moving on to a medium and one final heavy coat where you get the color and the shine. All right, so I'm going to finish gearing up, and then I'm gonna turn loose on this engine and tape it. If I have anything to say, I will probably, you know, hopefully with a computer, do a little bit of a voiceover so that you get to hear of any important information that comes up. In the meantime, you know, let me know what you think, and if you have any specific questions, you know where to find me. We're always in the Lab-RAT-ory, correct. All right, stay tuned. We'll be right back.
All right, everybody, here we go. This is enamel, and I'm shooting this at about 35 PSI. As you can see, it's very slow, kind of even strokes of the airbrush. You want to you don't want to get full coverage in the first few rounds, because you are going to obliterate the parts. That would be a lot of paint. Notice the overspray, which is why I recommend a booth. This is kind of a very relaxing stage for me always, you know, and I use the toothpick because it's you're able to spin it really fast with your fingers and get full coverage that way. Of course, the other tip of the toothpick gets stuck in my latex gloves, but that's okay. It actually guarantees that the thing is not going to fall out of your fingers. The rubber gloves create a nice, you know, holding utensil. Notice the paint is going on pretty well. This is already like maybe the third, fourth miscoat. This airbrush is a beauty. I've used it for many years, and you know, it does a fantastic job of covering parts with paint. Yep, that's the paint already coming on. You know, by the time your paint starts to look, especially metallics, you know, when it starts to get this sheen, you're on the right track. try to get every single nook and cranny, every crevice. You know, you want to shoot into your angles and panel lines. You know, there we go. Trying to make sure that everything is getting covered. The trigger airbrush is real easy to use, and it just feels different than normal because you're not using your pointing finger. You're just using, the next two couple of fingers, and it's very comfortable, you know. We are up to maybe a fifth coat. Now we're moving into the heavy, medium to heavy coats. You could see the part picking up the gloss already. You want full coverage, and then you also want to make sure you get the gloss on there because, you know, why not have the engine block be shiny like the rest of the vehicle? Once again, you could see a lot better that the paint is taking hold. The toothpick allows you to spin the part, you know, which is also why I use the chopsticks and two double-sided tape. It helps. It's good to keep, the paint to a particular area. You don't want to get the stuff all over the place. Always keep paper towels handy, something to wipe down your surface, and certainly you have to clean the airbrush afterwards. So whenever you're using urethanes or enamels, as this in this case, you need the thinner to clean the airbrush thoroughly. And it's a good deal that in this case we're using very cheap lacquer thinner, because, you know, it's not that expensive then to really clean the use a little bit extra to clean your brush. I believe we're getting to the final couple of coats here with the paint. You know, when you're making a video of a painting process, it almost looks like you're faking it because you're not, you know, the paint doesn't look like it's going on by this stage. It's, the part is already painted. So it's very hard to see the flow, but you see the big spot of overspray right next to the bottle. And later on, you will see where the bottle was. I removed the bottle, and you will see a circle all the way around. Here we go. Now we've got gloss. We've got shine. We are good to go. I believe we're just at the end. You know, always stop, inspect the parts. The first couple of mist coats, I would urge you to stop a little bit and let the paint take hold, and then come back, which is a normal process when you're doing multi parts. Here we go. This is done. All right. Very good.
Hey everybody. Well, as you can see, the engine has been painted. It took but 3-4 minutes to bring on the color. Okay. My recommendation is usually to apply a couple of coat, you know, mist coats. Okay, and let that set up just a little bit, and then come back in and do the medium to heavy coats. And you'll be okay. You know, I mean, it turned out perfectly fine. You know, and the toothpick, as you can see, helps hold the part, and everything's fine. You know, notice the overspray. This is what happens when you are spraying, you know, with the airbrush. It just gets everywhere. So you do need a booth. You need a way of containing all of that and getting it out of your immediate area, whether it's outside or, you know, whatever. But anyway, this is going to be the painted engine for the 56 Delray. And it's that simple. Just go slow, take your time, be patient, and use steady, even strokes. All right? I don't want to repeat probably what I will have to narrate, you know, what I just narrated in the previous section of this video. So there it is. All right. And then, of course, I get the little clip-on thingy. All right. And then I've got myself a little tripod right there. And I usually let this rest in a place where nothing's going to fall on it. And it should be good to go in the next couple of days. All right, we'll be back. Thank you, and please subscribe, comment, and generally shine. All right.